Hi guys, this is another tutorial about the new Frontier Verizon router. This is an Aries model. It's it's not so bad, but I occasionally run into some problems. And yesterday I had another problem. I wanted to connect a new tablet which I bought, and I've seen that this LED was blinking red. That's the Wi-Fi LED, and it was blinking. It was not steady red, it was blinking red, and I had no idea first, and I thought, yeah, it's, I don't care, no problem. So I tried to manually connect the tablet to this router, and it didn't work. So I found the Wi-Fi, but it said, yeah, it's recognized and secured, but it didn't connect. So I tried to use the WPS button here, and the same thing at the tablet, and tried to connect, and it didn't connect. It just kept blinking. And yeah, what you can do, you can try to find the problem, or you can just restart. Usually I would restart, but I have problems with my router. When I restart, I lose all the settings. Usually that's a little bit problem, and then I have to manually enter it again. So I decided to look for the problem, or find a specific solution without having to reboot the router. So I went to the internet and I found this manual. It's really difficult to find the manual. Maybe we can find it on the Frontier site, but here I found something. I will put this link to this thing below, of course, so you can always access if you need that. There are a few things you can see, a little bit simple description about everything. And here I found about Wi-Fi and another thing. So Wi-Fi flashing red means WPS timeout or conflict. Okay, so what I did, I went to the router, which is in my case 192.168.254.254.254, and so here we are on the main page. And to go to WPS, you have to click on wireless. Then here on the left side you have WPS, and of course you need the password and to change settings. And what I did is I clicked both radio selections and disabled them. So like this here, 2.4, disable and apply, and also 5 gigahertz disable apply. But yeah, the one which is already disabled, that is actually not necessary. So you can just turn one on, and you have to just turn the one which is on to off. Usually you will have the 2.4 gigahertz on, because that's the thing which every, or 99% of the equipment will be able to access. Older devices won't be able to access 5 gigahertz, so it doesn't make any sense to turn it on, the WPS, on the 5 gigahertz. It's much better to have it on the 2.4 gigahertz. So yeah, just disable that, push apply, and then turn it on again. Okay, when it takes maybe 10 seconds to come back for the screen, and then you go again to here, then you put activate, enable and apply, wait another 10 seconds, and then you get back to the router and check if you have again a green light, which was in my case. So yeah, then I took the tablet, activated WPS, push the button here to connect, and it connected within 2 seconds or so, and everything is fine again. So yeah, that's the solution which I worked for me. I hope it will work for you too. If you liked the video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching. See you next time.